This is part 12 of Azure tutorial. In our previous video, we discussed how to create a virtual machine scale set. In this video, we'll discuss the scaling options we have, that is, how to increase or decrease VM instances in a scale set. At this point, if you're thinking, why do we even need to increase or decrease VMs in a scale set? Well, there are a number of reasons. One reason could be most of your customers use your application during specific times of a day, maybe 10 a.m. to 12 noon, and then again from 3 p.m. to 5 p.m., for example. During these two windows, you want your application to be fast and performant. So you may want to increase the number of VM instances that run your application. Outside of these two windows, your application does not have that much demand, so to save on cost, you want to reduce the number of VMs that run your application. Another reason could be, next week, you're launching a new product or a business line. So starting next week, you're going to have a heavy peak maybe for 3 days. So during the heavy peak season, you want more VMs to run your application. Once the peak subsides, again, to save on cost, you want to fall back to your baseline configuration. And another reason could be you're in a situation where you cannot predict the demand for your application. So you don't really know when you need more processing power and when you can fall back to that baseline configuration. Well, for this, we can use metric-based auto-scaling. Now, in Azure, there are three options for scaling VM instances up and down: manually through the Azure portal, autoscale based on metrics, or autoscale based on a defined schedule. You can configure all these scaling options either at the time of creating the virtual machine scale set or after it is created. At the time of creating the scale set, you configure scaling on the scaling tab, as you can see right here. Now, in our case, we already created the virtual machine scale set in our previous video. At the moment, we are looking at that scale set. And as you can see, in this scale set, we have got three virtual machine instances. Now, to configure scaling for the virtual machine scale set that is already created, we do that on the scaling tab. Notice, we have two choices for scaling: manual scale and custom auto scale. With custom auto scale, again, we have two choices. We can scale on any defined schedule or based on any metrics. We'll look at custom auto scale in just a bit. First, let's take a look at this manual scale. So at the moment, we have manual scale selected, and in our scale set, we have three VMs. Now, let's increase this to 6. So let's change the number to 6 and then quickly click this button to save. And then immediately, let's flip over to instances. Notice we have three VMs already, and we want that to be increased to 6 VMs. And you can see it's creating another 5 instances. Probably this is a bit misleading. I'm sure after this process is completed, you know, it's going to take a few minutes, it's going to create another 3 VMs, taking the total VMs count to 6. So let's give it a few minutes. There we go. Our deployment is complete, and as expected, the number of VMs in our scale set is 6. Now let's go back to the scaling tab. At the moment, as you can see, we are using manual scale. In a real world, it's a bit tedious and time consuming if we have to manually scale out and scale in every time the demand for our application changes. However, it's an option just in case if you want to manually scale. Now let's take a look at custom auto scaling. Notice, as soon as I select this radio button, we have a default auto created scale condition, and we have two choices here: scale based on a metric or scale to a specific instance count. First, let's look at scale based on a metric. Here we have instance limits: the minimum number of VMs we want, the maximum number of VMs, and the default. Let's change the default to 2. This default setting is interesting. At the moment, we are scaling based on a metric. Let's say, for example, we are scaling based on CPU utilization. But what if Azure is not able to read CPU utilization metric? Well, we don't want our system to crash. We want our system to be still highly available. Now let's say at the moment within our scale set, we have one VM, and then we have specified the default count as 2, and we are scaling based on CPU utilization, and Azure is not able to read that metric. So what Azure is going to do is automatically increase the number of VM instances to the default number, that is 2, in case it is not able to read the metric based on which we are scaling, in this case CPU utilization. But the opposite is not going to happen, meaning let's say in our scale set we already have 3 VMs and we have specified the default as 2, and in case if we are not able to read the metric based on which we are scaling, in this case CPU utilization, it will not decrease the VM instances from 3 to 2. It will only scale out, not scale back in. Now let's add a scale rule. As you can see from the message here, no metric rules defined. So let's add a rule. At the moment, metric source for this scale rule, as you can see, is our virtual machine scale set itself, vmss demo. We have other metric sources if we want to. Next, time aggregation, we have average because our metric at the moment is percentage CPU utilization, and for percentage CPU utilization, average makes sense. We don't want minimum or maximum, so let's stick to average. If we scroll down a bit, notice at the moment average CPU percentage is 0.47%, and that makes sense because our VMs in the scale set are not doing much. So if average CPU percentage is greater than 70% for a duration of 10 minutes, that is for continuously 10 minutes, the average CPU percentage is greater than 70%, then we want to increase the instance count by 1. And then we have something called cool down time here, and it's in minutes, and at the moment the value is 5 minutes. And this is an interesting setting because after a scale operation is performed, in this case the instance count is increased by 1, we are going to give it 5 minutes to cool down so the metrics can stabilize before another scale operation can be performed. So let's add the scale rule. There we go, our scale out rule is added, and notice the message that we have here. It is recommended to have at least one scaling rule. Now, when there's a lot of demand for our application, we want more VMs, so we have a scale-out rule. We need to do the opposite as well. When the demand subsides, we want to reduce the number of VMs that run our application to save on cost. So it is recommended to have at least one scaling rule. So let's add that. Again, same idea. If the average CPU percentage is less than maybe 25%, then we want to decrease the instance count by 1. Again, the cooldown time is 5 minutes. Let's add this scaling rule. There we go, we have a scale out rule and a scale in rule. Let's save these changes. There is an error saving changes. Here is the error. The subscription must be registered to use namespace microsoft.insights. To fix this, let's fire up another browser tab and navigate to portal.azure.com. Once you're logged in, click on subscriptions. At the moment, I only have one subscription, so let's click on that. And on the subscription blade, scroll all the way down and look for resource providers. And the resource provider that we want to register is microsoft.insights. Here it is. Select that and then click this register button. There we go. Registration complete. Now let's try to save our changes. There we go. Our scale condition is successfully saved. We can also scale to a specific instance count. Let's actually add another scale condition, and this time select this radio button, scale to a specific instance count. In the text box here, you specify the instance count you want to scale to. So on 24th of December 2020 at 12 a.m. increase the instance count to 10, And on the same day, that is on 24th of December 2020 at 11:59 p.m., fall back to the baseline configuration. You can repeat this scale condition on a specific days of the week if you want to. So, bottom line, if your application demand increases, the load on the VM instances in your scale set also may increase. If this increased load is consistent rather than just a brief demand, you can configure autoscale rules both to increase and reduce the number of VM instances in the scale set. That's it in this video. Thank you for listening.